Here's some of the stories trending this week at NASA. The October 10th spacewalk outside the International Space Station was the second in less than a week by NASA's Randy Bresnik and Mark Vande, and one of three U.S. spacewalks planned for October. The astronauts lubricated the new latching end effector they installed on the Canadarm2 robotic arm on October 5th. They also replaced a faulty camera system and completed several other tasks. Joe Acaba will join Bresnik for the next spacewalk, currently scheduled for October 20th. On October 9th, NASA's Aqua satellite captured this natural color image of several wildfires burning in Northern California. Heat, low humidity, and intense winds complicated the ability of firefighters to control these fires, several of which were burning in Sonoma Valley and Napa Valley, the heart of California's wine country. Data from several satellites, including our Orbiting Carbon Observatory 2, or OCO2, show that the impacts of heat and drought during the last El Niño on Earth's tropical regions caused the record spike in global atmospheric carbon dioxide, or CO2, levels in 2015 and 2016. Our planet's three largest tropical forests each responded to the El Niño differently, but all added to the largest annual increases in atmospheric carbon dioxide concentration seen in at least 2,000 years. NASA's InSight lander is headed to Mars next year, and it could carry your name with it. Visit mars.nasa.gov/syn by November 1st to add your name to a silicon microchip that will hitch a ride to the red planet, joining another microchip filled with nearly 827,000 names back in 2015. Be sure to also check out details about the frequent flyer program at the site and other ways you can participate in NASA's exploration of Mars. InSight will be the first mission to explore far below the Martian surface. October 14th marks the 70th anniversary of the first piloted supersonic flight made by Air Force pilot Chuck Yeager. During the historic flight, Yeager's X-1 experimental research aircraft flew at around 700 miles an hour in the skies above California. The X-plane legacy continues today at NASA, where we're designing a supersonic demonstration aircraft that aims to quiet the loud sonic boom associated with supersonic flight today. On October 12th, the close approach to Earth of a small asteroid provided an opportunity for asteroid trackers around the world to test their ability to operate as a coordinated international asteroid warning network. The asteroid, 2012 TC4, flew by at a safe distance of approximately 26,000 miles. This test of a global asteroid impact and early warning system is a volunteer project conceived and organized by NASA-funded asteroid observers and supported by the agency's Planetary Defense Coordination Office, or PDCO. And that's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at www.nasa.gov.